Shall we pray? Father, thank you for another opportunity to be a blessing to your people today. This word will go forth with all clarity and simplicity with the power of God in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. I'm Reverend Gbade Ugunlana. I'm the darling pastor and Paitowa. I'm continuing with the series of teachings on the gifts of the Spirit. And like I told us last week, we are starting with the nine gifts of the Spirit, but we are going to concentrate this year on the vocal gifts of the Spirit. Pastor, which ones are the vocal gifts? They are the gifts that has to do with speaking. In 1 Corinthians chapter 12, starting from verse 1, Bible stated the nine gifts of the Spirit. 1 Corinthians chapter 12, let me start from verse 6. The Bible says, and there are diversities of operation, but it is the same God which worketh all in all. But the manifestation of the Spirit is given to every man to profit with all. For to one is given by the Spirit with the word of wisdom, to another the word of knowledge by the same Spirit, to another faith by the same Spirit, to another gifts of healings by the same Spirit, to another the working of miracles, and to another prophecy, to another discerning of spirits, to another diverse kind of tongues, to another the interpretation of tongues. Here the Bible stated nine gifts or manifestations of the Holy Spirit: the word of wisdom, word of knowledge, and discerning of spirits, the gift of faith, the working of miracles and gifts of healing, prophecy, diverse kind of tongues, and the interpretation of tongues. These nine gifts of the Spirit are like the instruments that the Father God released into his body for the effectual working of his power in the midst of his people. Now, there are nine gifts of the Spirit. We can divide them effectively into three. How? Because we realize that three of them have to do or operate in a particular pattern. For example, out of these nine gifts of the Spirit, three of them have to do with speaking. Three of them have to do with power or manifestation of power. While there are three of them that have to do with revelation. So looking at that, we can actually divide them into three categories. The category of those that have to do with speaking, then the categories of those that have to do with revelation, then the categories of that has to do with the manifestations of the power of God. As I promised, we are going to sit down and study those that have to do with speaking. And these are prophecy, diverse kind of tongues, and the interpretation of tongues. Prophecy, diverse kind of tongues, and the interpretation of tongues. Now, the first thing I want us to realize about these three gifts that is that they have to do with speaking. This is why we can call them vocal gifts. They have to do with speaking. Sometimes they are referred to as inspirational gifts. Why? Because they are meant to inspire. Prophecy, diverse kind of tongues, and the interpretation of tongues. If you go around and you look around churches these days, you will hardly see manifestations of these gifts. Pastor, is it that God has withdrawn them away from us? No. They are meant to be with us. Hallelujah. Till the coming of the Lord Jesus Christ. They are gifts of the Holy Spirit. As long as the Holy Spirit is with us, they are meant to be manifested in our midst. Then why don't we see them, Pastor? One of the reasons is because we have not been taught much along that line. We may need to make some adjustment also in our system and in our approach. For example, there are a lot of churches that, everything is fast food mentality now. You have a church that we want to do worship, we want to do prayer, we want to do teaching, we want to collect offering, we want to give announcement, all in 45 minutes. There is no place or space for the manifestations of the gifts of the Spirit. when you see Acts of the Apostles chapter 5, you notice there that when there was the manifestation of the working of miracles, you remember Ananias and Sapphira, when one of them fell dead, they were still in the same meeting. The Bible says 3 hours after, in the same meeting. That is a clue to show one of the reasons why we have not been seeing much manifestations. Many times our meetings are too short for the manifestations of the Holy Ghost. They were still in the same meeting 3 hours after. No wonder there was the manifestations of the Holy Ghost. When we want to wrap up everything in 1 hour, it is difficult for the Spirit of God to manifest. Many times we have boxed him and we do not see these manifestations. May God just help us so that we'll be able to do what we ought to do to get the job done and allow the Spirit of God to have a free flow in our midst. Now, concerning the gifts of the vocal gifts of the Spirit, there is something peculiar about them. You realize that in the Bible, in 1 Corinthians chapter 14, there were a lot of corrections, instructions about their manifestations. Unlike the word of wisdom, the word of knowledge, have you discovered that no matter how much you study the Bible, you won't necessarily know even the definition of the word of wisdom or word of knowledge? You may see the manifestation, but if you don't know the definition, you won't even know that they are the ones manifesting. But you have a lot of instructions on the vocal gifts of the Spirit, prophecy, diverse kind of tongues, and the interpretation of tongues. Pastor, why? One of the major reasons is because the vocal gifts of the Spirit make use of us more than others. Pastor, what do you mean? When you prophesy, you are the one speaking. When you interpret, you are the one speaking. The vocal gifts of the Spirit manifest through us. And you know, because we are imperfect vessels, a whole lot of time, many of us may allow our carnality to be mixed with the genuine thing that God is passing through us. And that is why the Bible gave us the liberty to judge prophecy, to judge the interpretation and the manifestations of the diverse kind of tongues. Why do we need to judge them? Because they pass through us. The Bible says, "He that speaketh in an unknown tongue." Pastor, I thought it's the Holy Spirit that will force it out of my mouth. No. You are the one that will speak. 1 Corinthians chapter 14, verse 2. He that speaketh in tongue. That is why he said in that verse, verses 27 and 28, thereabout, that if the prophet speaks, let the other judge. We are permitted by the Bible to judge prophecy and the interpretation of tongues because of the fact that we are imperfect vessels. And these vocal gifts pass through us. But what I want to establish in this particular teaching is the fact that these three vocal gifts of the Spirit, prophecy, diverse kind of tongues, and the interpretation of tongues, they are primarily meant to be used in our individual lives as well as in the church. That is, the gift of prophecy, diverse kind of tongues, interpretation of tongues are meant also to be used in our individual lives. God wants you and me to be praying a lot in tongues. Paul the Apostle said, "I thank my God, I speak in tongues more than ye all." So it is the plan of God that we have time to pray in an unknown tongues. Now in 1 Corinthians chapter 14, verse 13, the Bible now stated something. 1 Corinthians chapter 14, verse 13. But before I read that verse 13, let me first read 1 Corinthians chapter 14, verse 2. "For he that speaketh in an unknown tongues." So number one, God wants us to be speaking in tongues. In verse 13 now, the Bible says, "Wherefore let him that speaketh in an unknown tongue pray that he may interpret." Let him that speaketh in an unknown tongue pray that he may interpret. So not only does God encourage us to pray in tongues, the Bible says that we should pray that we may be able to interpret our tongues. So it is like this. In our individual lives, God designs it that we pray in tongues and also interpret our tongues. That is rich spiritual life. Many of us have craved for the manifestations of the Holy Ghost in our lives. But you know, one of the most important things is for Him to be manifesting in our individual lives. I can bet it if a church of 20 people should gather together and every single one of them have taken 1 hour, 2 hours to pray in tongues before coming together, they are going to have a spectacular meeting. Because individuals have inspired themselves from their homes. When they now come together, no, they don't come as a load unto the pastor. They will come as a contributor to the service. So God designs it that we have a time of speaking in tongues in our individual lives, a time of interpreting the tongues that we speak in our individual lives. In fact, there is the use of the spirit of prophecy in our private personal prayer lives. God wants us to use this. So the teaching, what I'm establishing today, is the fact that there are 3 vocal gifts of the Spirit, according to 1 Corinthians chapter 12. The Bible talks about the gift of prophecy, diverse kind of tongues, and the interpretation of tongues. These are manifestations of the Holy Spirit that have to do with speaking. The plan of God is that they be manifested when we come together as a church. But on the other hand, the plan of God is that we use them in our private, personal, individual lives. God wants you and me to be able to use the spirit of prophecy in our praying, to be able to pray in tongues and give the interpretation of the tongues. Those are the plans, the purpose, and the will of God for our individual lives. He wants us to live an enriched life. He wants us to live a life of spiritual enrichment. And that is why, as you do that on your individual lives, when we now come together, it becomes easier for us to flow unhindered. It becomes easier for us to flow in the things of God. There are many hearts that are yearning for the manifestations of the Spirit of God. I took it upon myself to teach, especially between now and the end of the year, on this subject, because looking around, you find out that the churches that we met when we were growing up are no longer the churches that we see around today. In those old days, hardly will you be in the church for 2-3 weeks without somebody standing up saying, "Thus saith the Lord." Hardly will you be in the church without somebody standing up giving utterances in tongues and another standing up to interpret it. We hardly see them today. There are a lot of this young generation that do not even have understanding how the church should look like. They think a church is a place whereby the pastor comes around and develop an unusual skill in collecting and raising offering. No, church is more than that. How do we get to where we ought to be? Number one, through teaching. That is why we are teaching God's word, so that everywhere the power of God will be made manifested and we'll be able to flow more in the things of God. Some years ago, in the early years ago, in this city of Ibadan, we had testimonies of a woman that was pregnant for 4 days. She died. A pregnant woman that died for 4 days. And people came together, prayed, and she was raised. The amazing miracle about it is this. This woman delivered the child safely. You know, we crave for such a thing. Has God changed? He has not changed. He's the same yesterday, today, and forever. He never changes. He will not change. He cannot change. And this is why where you and me comes in. We are the ones that need to come up with Him. We need to come up to Him. He never changes. He's the same yesterday, today, and forever. Jesus is the same yesterday, today, and forever. Holy Ghost is the same yesterday, today, and forever. We need to come up in the manifestations of the things of God. But don't forget, this all starts with you taking enough time to pray in an unknown tongue. Charge yourself up. Take time to pray in tongues. That is where to start. By the grace of God, next week, I will continue to teach on this, the interpretation of tongues and using the spirit of prophecy in our individual personal prayer life. God wants us to be able to flow in this in our private prayer lives before we move into the church. His purpose is that there be manifestations in the church, but it begins with Him manifesting our individual lives. Take time to pray in an unknown tongues. then you flow into the spirit of interpreting the tongues, then you flow into prophecy. By the grace of God, I'm going to continue with this teaching next week. I'm Reverend Gbade Ugunlana, the darling pastor and Paitowa. See you next week.